What will the end of the universe be like? Five theories that explain it. In our way of thinking, everything with a beginning also has an end. Today we know that the universe has a beginning, the Big Bang. Therefore, it will also have an end. But what will that end be like? When will it happen? What will happen when the universe dies out? Keep watching to find out. Since humanity began to be aware of its existence, we also began to ask ourselves many questions about our mortality. Where did we come from? Where are we going? How did it all start, and how will it end? These are some of the questions that we have always asked ourselves, but today, thanks to the advancements of science and technology, for the first time in history, we may have solid answers to those questions. Observing the universe, we have determined how it evolves and how it could end. Then we present the five most accepted theories that explain the end of the universe. Big Freeze. The Big Freeze theory, also known as freeze death, is one of the most widely accepted hypotheses about the final fate of the universe. This theory is based on the idea that the universe is expanding faster and faster and will eventually cool down to near absolute zero, leading to the extinction of all life and the disappearance of all matter. This theory is derived from the second law of thermodynamics, which states that the entropy of a closed system always increases with time. Entropy refers to the amount of disorder in a system, and according to this law, the amount of disorder in the universe will always increase with time. As the universe expands, the amount of energy available is diluted, resulting in a decrease in entropy. This means that the universe is cooling down, and eventually all energy will be dispersed entirely, and the temperature will drop to absolute zero. The Big Freeze theory suggests that the universe's expansion will continue indefinitely, and as it expands, the density of matter and energy will decrease. Over time, the stars will run out of fuel and burn out, leaving a cold, dark universe. All that will remain are isolated subatomic particles and the elementary particles that make up the universe. Interestingly, the Big Freeze theory also has implications for the theory of biological evolution, as it suggests that life in the universe has only a limited amount of time to evolve before the universe cools and dies. This suggests that life is a fleeting and rare phenomenon, only having a chance to exist for a short time in cosmic time. Although the Big Freeze theory may seem bleak, it also invites us to appreciate life and existence as we know it today. Big Crunch. The Big Crunch theory is one of the fascinating hypotheses about the end of the universe. This theory is based on the idea that the universe is not infinite but has a limit. Furthermore, it's argued that the currently observed expansion of the universe will eventually reverse, giving rise to a contraction that will culminate in a moment of total collapse. According to this theory, the universe is continuously expanding due to dark energy, but gravity will eventually overcome the force of expansion and start to contract. As the universe compresses, the density and temperature will increase dramatically. Eventually, the universe will collapse into a tiny point of infinite density and temperature, known as a singularity. This collapse of the universe is similar to the Big Bang, but instead of a vast explosion that creates the universe, there will be a collapse that destroys it. The Big Crunch is like a reversal of the Big Bang, a kind of big bounce that marks the end of one era and the beginning of another. The Big Crunch was first proposed in the 1960s and 1970s by theorists like Stephen Hawking and Roger Penrose. Although this theory has been considered one of the possible ways the universe could end, it is unknown if this will happen. The most compelling evidence for the Big Crunch comes from studying the universe's density. According to Einstein's theory of general relativity, the universe's density determines its geometry and fate. The universe will contract if the universe's density is more significant than a particular critical value. If the universe's density is less than the critical value, the universe will continue to expand forever. If the universe's density is equal to the critical value, the universe will expand indefinitely at a slower and slower rate. Observations of cosmic background radiation have allowed astronomers to estimate the universe's density. Although there is still significant uncertainty in these calculations, the largest measurements suggest that the universe's density is close to the critical value, suggesting that the universe could be destined to collapse. Big Chill. The third theory about the universe's future is eternal expansion, also known as the Big Chill theory. This hypothesis proposes that the universe will continue to expand indefinitely, getting colder and colder, until it finally reaches a temperature close to absolute zero. The basis of this theory is the observation that the universe is constantly expanding. This expansion is believed to be due to dark energy, a form of energy that appears to be accelerating the universe's expansion rate. Dark energy is a mysterious force that is not yet fully endorsed by scientists, but it is believed to account for approximately 68% of the total energy content of the universe. According to the Big Chill theory, as the universe continues to expand, the density of matter and energy will decrease more and more, meaning there will be fewer collisions and fewer interactions between particles. As a result, the universe's temperature will also decrease, since the temperature is related to the momentum and kinetic energy of the particles. Eventually, according to this theory, the universe will reach a state of thermodynamic equilibrium, where all matter will be evenly distributed, and the temperature will be uniform throughout the universe. At this point, the universe will be close to absolute zero, the lowest possible temperature, and all chemical and physical reactions will stop. This final state is called thermal death, and is considered one of the possible endings of the universe. Although the theory of eternal expansion seems to be a realistic possibility for the universe's future, it is still controversial. Some scientists argue that dark energy may not be constant and may decrease in the future, which could impact the universe's expansion. Others suggest that there could be unknown phenomena that could change the way the universe expands. Big Rip. This theory suggests that the universe will continue to expand, but at some point in the future, the expansion will accelerate so much that gravitational forces cannot hold together the most significant structures in the universe, such as galaxies and stars. This will result in the destruction of everything that exists in the universe, including matter, energy, and the very fabric of space-time. The universe would be torn to pieces, hence the name Big Rip Theory. This theory is based on the idea that dark energy, the same mysterious force that drives the universe's accelerating expansion, becomes stronger and stronger as the universe expands. As dark energy grows more powerful, it exerts an even greater force on space and matter, accelerating the universe's expansion to even faster levels. The Big Rip theory suggests that ultimately dark energy will be so strong that it will overcome even the gravitational force in the universe, causing all cosmic structures to be ripped apart into smaller fragments. This would include galaxies, stars, and the subatomic particles that make up all matter in the universe. While this theory may seem quite apocalyptic, there is still much unknown about dark energy and its impact on the universe's expansion. Scientists are working to understand better this mysterious force and how it may influence the future of the universe. As with other theories, the Big Rip also has its detractors. Some scientists argue that dark energy will not necessarily increase forever and could sometimes weaken or disappear. Others believe that there may be unknown forces that could interfere with the universe's expansion and prevent it from tearing itself apart. Cyclical Universe. The cyclic universe theory, also known as the oscillating universe theory, proposes that the universe has an endless cycle of expansion and contraction. In this theory, the universe expands over billions of years until it reaches its peak and begins to contract again. Once it has reached a small enough size, the universe squeezes into an infinitesimally small point known as a singularity. Then it explodes in a colossal explosion called the Big Bang, triggering a new expansion cycle. According to this theory, the universe does not have a definite beginning or end, but has existed and will continue to exist continuously. Instead of a single Big Bang, there would have been a series of expansion and contraction cycles, each starting with a Big Bang and ending with a contraction until the singularity. In this way, the Big Bang was the death of the previous universe and the birth of this new universe in which we live. One of the main pieces of evidence supporting this theory comes from the discovery of cosmic background radiation, a glow of radiation found throughout the universe that is believed to be the remnant of the Big Bang. According to the theory of the cyclical universe, this cosmic background radiation is evidence that the universe has gone through cycles of expansion and contraction and that the radiation would have cooled and scattered into space during the contraction process. However, the cyclic universe theory is not widely accepted. Some scientists argue that observational evidence is insufficient to support the idea of a cyclical universe, and that the theory cannot explain certain cosmological phenomena, such as the accelerating expansion of the universe that has been observed in recent years. Furthermore, the theory also raises the question of whether the information contained in the universe can be conserved through each cycle of contraction and expansion. If the universe is destined to repeat itself over and over again, how can the growth of complexity in the universe over time be explained? Despite these limitations, the cyclical universe theory remains a fascinating hypothesis that continues to be the subject of the scientific community's study and debate in the science. The entire understanding of the future of the universe remains a mystery, and further research and exploration will be needed to unlock the secrets of the cosmos. Reflecting on the proposed theories about the ultimate fate of the universe, we find ourselves with a spectrum of possibilities ranging from external expansion to the eventual extinction of the universe. All these theories share the idea that the universe is constantly changing and evolving, which leads us to reflect on our existence. Thinking about the end of the universe helps us to remember that we too will die sooner or later, since in this universe, nothing is eternal, not even the universe itself. By reflecting on the eventual demise, we can find the motivation to make the most of our existence and work to leave a positive legacy. Ultimately, the study of the future of the universe invites us to explore the most profound questions about human existence and our place in the cosmos. It reminds us that life is precious and fleeting, and we must work together to preserve and protect life in all its forms. May this knowledge inspire us to continue exploring the universe and discovering the mysteries that remain to be solved before it all ends. And you, how do you think the end of the universe will be? Let us know your opinion in the comments.